Because all of our entities are simulated using physics bodies, we lack the ability to simply move our player to our desired position. This type of teleportation can cause issues with your physics environment. Mainly, teleported objects ignore physics calculations until after their teleportation has been resolved. For instance, if we move the player to a teleported position, which is intersected with the wall, we could potentially get stuck there, and then confuse the physics engine on what to do next, since the player is, of course, stuck. As such, rather than teleporting the player, we need to update its velocity such that the physics engine moves that unit to where we want it to go next update loop. Now, all of our players actually have an MP physics body variable. This physics body is given to us on the instantiation of the player by allocating it from the physics engine. Since we can't set the physics body position directly due to teleportation issues, what we do instead is a little bit of a workaround. We take advantage of the fact that the physics engine is going to update all of the physics bodies that it owns every frame. The physics bodies themselves allow you to define a velocity vector on them. When the physics engine updates, it adjusts the position of the physics body by the vector, moving it correctly. We, in Grits, can take advantage of this by supplying a velocity vector that will move our physics body to the position we want it to be in, avoiding the teleportation issues.